Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have discussed about what is electronegativity as well as what are the factors that will affect the electronegativity when it comes to the element. So now what we are going to do is we are going to talk about what are the periodic trends that we are going to see about electronegativity of the elements that are present in periodic table. So let us talk about that. So now we are going to talk about the trends in electronegativity in periodic table, that is for the elements, or we could say that what are the variations that we could see for electronegativity when we are talking about the elements in periodic table. So let us talk about the first trend that we have did earlier also, but we are going to do now again, that is in periods. So what are the variations that we could see in electronegativities for the elements that are in the periods of a periodic table? So for that, let me give you a short idea, because as we know that in periodic table, suppose this is the schematic diagram of periodic table as we know. And as we know that if we move along the period, or if we move along the period, that is from left to right, okay. So if we move along the period, then what we could see that in periods, actually the first thing that we could see is atomic number increases. Yes, the atomic number increases. And if atomic number increases, but with this kind of increase we could see gradually, or we could see that the atomic number is increasing by a unit. Or for example, if I would say for lithium, if the atomic number is 3, then for beryllium it is 4, and for boron it is 5. So always what happens is the atomic number goes on gradual increase. So therefore I could write that the atomic number goes on increasing gradually. And moreover, if the atomic number goes on increasing gradually, and the electrons that are being added in the shell will be in the last shell itself, and there will be no kind of increase in the number of shell as per as we could see in as we generally know that in periods the number of outermost shell will remain the same, or the number of main shell remains the same. So in this case what happens is the electron enters in the last shell and making the density of the electron in the outermost shell to be more, so as they could attract the innermost nucleus, making the atomic size to be reduced. So the atomic size, yes, the atomic size decreases as you move from left to right. And if the atomic size decreases, then we could say that the nuclear charge will go on increasing, because it is nothing but the attraction of the nucleus with the outermost electron. So the distance of the nucleus and the outermost electron is less, or we could say because of the nuclear charge the atomic size is less. So that makes the nuclear charge to be more if we move from left to right. So as we move from left to right, we could see that the nuclear charge goes on increasing, and that increase we could see in that is from, suppose if I talk about lithium, and suppose if lithium is the one that is belonging to the first period, suppose if I am concerned with that. So after lithium, the element that comes, it is beryllium, then boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen and fluorine, and then neon, that is a noble gas. So in this case what we could see is as we move from left to right, then the atomic number increases by unitary, or we could say just for lithium it is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So this goes on, and the atomic size goes on decreasing. This makes the nuclear charge to go on increasing. And hence we could say, because of the increase in nuclear charge, we could say that the electronegativity of those elements also increase when it comes to the trend, or when it comes to the variation in periodic table, when we are concerned with the periods or the elements that are present in the periods. So therefore in this case, when we are talking about the electronegativity, so the electronegativity will have a basically sequence that we could see that in this case the fluorine will have the most electronegative, it will be the most electronegative in the whole period. So therefore this will have more electronegativity than that of oxygen, than that of nitrogen, than that of carbon, boron, beryllium and lithium. So this makes the fluorine to be the most electronegative element in the whole period, when we are talking about period. So that is the trend that we could see. So not just in the first period or the second period, but in this case we could see in every kind of period, we could see this kind of, usually this kind of general change that we could, this kind of general variation that we could see in a period. But in this case, have you noticed I have not mentioned about the noble gas? Yes, I have not mentioned about the noble gas like neon, because neon are those substances, or the noble gases are those substances which do not form bond with any other elements more easily. So they don't form bond. So because of, since they are not forming a bond in a usual case, so what happens is that the question about the electronegativity, this doesn't arise. So that's the reason we have not mentioned here the noble gases, and that's the reason, in spite of being neon at the extreme right of the periodic table, the electronegativity of that won't be considered, because fluorine is the most electronegative element in the whole periodic table when it comes to atomic size or when it comes to the nuclear charge. So this was the thing about the period. So let us talk about what kind of variation that we could see in groups. So now talking about in groups, so again I will take the same example. Suppose if we are talking about groups, then groups are those which move when we move from up to down, or we could say when we move vertically from up to down. So in this case, this is nothing but the number of groups that we could see. So therefore, and as we know that there are total number of 18 groups in a modern periodic table and 7 periods in a modern periodic table. So let us consider any one of the group. Suppose I am considering the first group. So as we know that as we are moving down the group, the atomic number increases, and that increase is not gradual, that is actually rapid, or we could say there is, we could see more difference between the atomic number. So that is what we have concerned with. So in groups, what happens is the atomic number increases, but rapidly. And moreover, we could see that the atomic size also goes on increasing. So in this case, the atomic size increases. And moreover, we could see, because of the atomic size goes on increasing and the number of shells also increases. So this makes the innermost shell to acquire more electrons, and because of which the inner shells, if acquire more electrons, then this would rise to give shielding effect. So if the shielding effect is more, then obviously the nuclear charge or the attraction of the nucleus towards the outermost electron, it will be less. And because if it would be less, then we could say that the atomic size will go on increasing, or we could also say in this manner that the electronegativity will not be more, because an atom will not have an attraction towards its outermost electron that much. So how can it attract the electron of the other atom when they are forming a covalent bond? So that makes us to know that when it comes to group, so electronegativity goes on decreasing. So let me give you an example of this case. Suppose if we are talking about suppose the first group, and in this case the first group has elements like lithium, sodium, as we are moving downwards. Okay, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, and francium. So in this case, suppose if we are moving from up to down or down the group, and in this case what we have got to know that the lithium is the one which has lower, or which has a smallest atomic size. So that smallest atomic size of the lithium makes the lithium to have more nuclear charge, and moreover there would be less shielding effect, and moreover when we are talking about electronegativity, it will have more electronegativity. But talking about the francium, which is present at the lowermost, at the extreme left bottom of the periodic table. So this francium is basically having a larger size. And as you know that if the atomic size goes on increasing, the nuclear charge will be less, and moreover we could see that the shielding effect will be more, and because of which the nuclear charge will be less, and ultimately the electronegativity will be less. So this indicates that when it comes to the order of electronegativity, then we could say clearly that lithium will have more electronegativity than that of the sodium, than that of potassium, rubidium, cesium and francium. So what we have noticed is in groups the atomic number goes on increasing with decrease in the electronegativity. So electronegativity goes on decreasing as we move from up to down or down the group, but as we move from left to right in the period that we are talking about, then the atomic size goes on decreasing with increasing electronegativity. So this kind of variation that we are observing in periodic table, so that is what this topic was made for, so as to make you understand that this is the variation that we see in terms of electronegativity in periodic table. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly and you have got to know this concept also very clearly. So share this video with your friends and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much.